Hi everybody, Kenneth G. Hasty here once again. A series of videos for professionals, for business people, for people in general. And this one is called Feeling Overwhelmed Lately. And what do I mean by that? Well, I took a little time this weekend and purposely didn't multitask on things. And then, you know, today I feel so much more refreshed. And ironically, I was reading an article by famous author of Barking Up the Wrong Tree, Eric Barker. So I'm going to kind of, you know, put my own thoughts into this, but base this video on Eric's article because I thought it was really good. You know, the end of last week, I was feeling really stressed out. And I was like, man, why am I so stressed out? And, you know, I realized that, you know, I'm never more than a few seconds from my mobile phone, from my smartphone, right? And even when I'm watching TV, I'm checking my emails and I'm checking my social media and I'm doing all this. And, you know, then I came across this article and it started making more sense. So you'll see my eyes glance down like this to read a little bit once in a while. And I'll kind of give you some ideas. So Eric's article is called 7 Ways Not to Feel Overwhelmed All the Time. And he quotes the studies show that most people are feeling like they're working harder, yet actually the hours worked are not any more these days than they have been in the past few decades. So what changed? And this is me paraphrasing here a little bit. I'll tell you what changed. You think about, you know, the internet has only been around a couple decades, right? And, you know, now we're all totally dependent upon it. But, you know, before that, people, you know, they get home from work, they turn on the TV, they've got a phone hanging on the wall, you know, life was different. They go work and then they come home and they were done with work, you know. Nowadays, our work's with us all the time. We're checking 24/7, it seems like, you know. We're getting text, pages, blah, 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 you know, we're getting emails, we're checking our social messages, we're getting, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And do we really ever take a break? And, you know, you got to think about that. What is a break? Well, so what I started trying to do is leave my phone in a different room sometimes, you know. I mean, typically I'll have it, I take a shower, my phone's sitting right there, you know, if I hear it ring, I can grab it or whatever. Now it's like, you know what, I'm going to take my friggin' shower, I'm going to relax and I can call somebody back, right? Things like that, you know, I set my phone to do not disturb now for the middle of the night hour. So people start texting me or, you know, get these social media dings and whatever. I'll find out the morning is not that urgent. So let me talk about the article a little bit, and it'll show some of these things as well. You know, it talks about the need to take time to rest, you know. And, you know, even God rested on the seventh day, right? Yeah, we humans don't seem to rest, and our brains aren't wired for that. It talks about how your brain actually shrinks if you're trying to multitask and push too hard and do too much. So let's think about this. Why are we feeling these feelings of overwhelm all the time? Yeah, me too, right? And, well, let's take a look at it. How can we get around that? How can we fix it? One thing is write it down. You know, when you worry about something, you think about it over and over, right? I hope that doesn't happen. Oh, gee, I hope I get that. I hope the money comes in. I hope whatever it is, right? So if you just write it down and forget about it, you know, maybe pray about it, but, you know, forget about it, then you've got a reference. You can go back and look later, but you get it out of your head, right? Prioritize or die. I like that because, you know, we're always busy, 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 busy all the time, busy doing things. But what we're not necessarily being is productive, right? So if we kind of look at what we're doing, is it a priority? Is it something we need to do? Is it something we just want to do? Is it something we feel like we just ought to do, you know? So do the things you need to do, right? Make things automatic, you know, create habits, check things at certain times of the day, you know. Just about everybody you read in productivity says, check your email at certain times during the day. Check your, you know, just like your mail. You check your mail what, once a day, you know, you don't keep looking at your mailbox all the time. So, you know, if something's, what I try to tell people communicating with me, if it's urgent, call me. If it's, you know, time sensitive, but not really urgent, text me. And if you just want to get a hold of me, shoot me an email or write me a letter or something, you know. But that's how I'm viewing these things these days. Let's talk about also to automate things. What about using a CRM? You know, a lot of you are still using Excel or if even that to try to keep track of all your contacts and all your work. or automating your email, your follow-up, or automating a lot of things. Anyway, I'm certified in that, so get a hold of me on the side after this video if you're interested in talking more about that. Work like an athlete. Well, you think athlete work all the time. Well, they do. They work out a lot on a regular schedule, but you know what they do a lot? They rest a lot. They take breaks. They think. They sleep well. You know, they're not working 24/7. They burn out and die, right? So your brain's not that different than that. Make sure when you're working, you're giving your brain a chance to rest, to relax, to think, to, you know, et cetera, right? Switch to single tasking. You know, a lot of research shows that multitasking, you just plain don't get things done as well. You think you do because you think you're accomplishing a lot because you're doing a little on this, a little on that, a little on this, but you're actually disengaged. You're to the point of almost scoring as a drunk person would. So if you can focus on something, get it done, focus on it, get it done, you're in much better shape. Which is live in Ohio. I do live in Ohio, but often not this Ohio, which Ohio means only handle it once. Only handle it once. You know, I hear that all the time, and I'm trying to get better at that myself, right? One of the worst things that happens is like an email sits there, or I get something in the mail and it just sits there and it just kind of recycles on my desk. And it just, you know, I just need to get it done. Just handle it once and be done. Right. Right. Another thing is, quit role switching. So what's role switching? This is actually part of one of the previous ones. Role switching is like, let's take like a single mom or, you know, you're a business person, but you're a home person. So maybe you're a coach and you're trying to do all these things at once. You're a coach, but you're checking your email to see how work's going. And then you got to switch to talk to your kid, you know, and now you're in dad mode. And, you know, focus on one thing at a time. You're there to coach, be the coach. Turn your phone off, for goodness sake, you know, spend time with your family. Do things like that. Single mom, same thing, you know, dedicate some time. You know, you got to dedicate time to your family, to your friends. You're eating dinner with your kids, eat dinner with your kids. You know, sit there and look at the TV or the phone and all that kind of stuff. Spend some quality time. You know, these days people joke about it, but people just sit there like this, you know, looking at their phone, you know, kids all sitting there together right at the table. You know, if they communicate at all, they're probably texting each other, right? So, you know, and the other ones have leisure goals. And that's so important, right? So what do you do in your leisure time? You know, I find myself watching a movie, but checking my phone, checking my email. I might have a computer on one knee and my cell phone on my other hand while I'm quote unquote watching a movie, right? Well, so I'm trying to get better at that. So focus on leisure time and also like vacation time. You know, I've got timeshare down in New Orleans I just love. And it's like if I focus, okay, in X amount of time, I'll be going down there for a week and just hanging out and enjoying the food and the culture and the music and et cetera, you know, But if you look forward to that and even pin something on your refrigerator maybe that reminds you of that, you know, leisure time is really important. Remember, even God rested on the seventh day. So anyway, so I want to thank Eric Barker for putting that article together. And like I said, it's called 7 Ways Not to Feel Overwhelmed All the Time. And I think if we work on that, maybe we can enjoy not feeling so overwhelmed. So good luck with that. Kenneth G. Hasty, I'm a professional business growth consultant. I'm a professional sales automation consultant, and I'm here to help. So if you've got a small business, you want to make it a bigger business, I'm the guy you call. Anyway, you can email me, Kenneth@KennethGHasty.com. You can check me out at KennethGHasty.com. Or if you'd like to give me a call, set a time that fits my schedule, then I'll even put a link in the bottom of this in the writing somewhere that'll let you just sync with my calendar and give me a call. Let's talk. All right, Kenneth G. Hasty signing off. I'm going to go work on something else now. See, I wasn't multitasking during this video. See, you can do it. You can. Take care. Bye.